So IPR stand for intellectual property right. Basically, we know that there are some properties that are physically that we can see. For example, land is there. For example, car is there. So you have a right on that because RC with you or registry is with you. But there are some properties which are not physically there. Okay, for example, you created one software. So software you can't see. This is not a, just like a book because this is a coding. Clear? So this type of property, which for example, you made one painting, you draw one painting, ठीक है? पेंटिंग का जो आइडिया है वो आपकी प्रॉपर्टी है, ठीक है? एंड अनदर पर्सन कैन कॉपी दैट पेंटिंग, क्लियर? सो द आइडिया इज नॉट फिजिकल देयर, सो द प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज ऑन द थिंग्स विच आर नॉट फिजिकली एग्जिस्ट इज कॉल्ड इंटरेक्ट आईपीआर, ठीक है? उसके पे जो राइट होता है दैट राइट इज कॉल्ड आईपीआर। हर्षिका इट इज क्लियर बेटा? क्लियर?
यस सर,
सो आई
यस सर,
यस आईपीआर आर द राइट ऑफ द ओनर ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टू डिसाइड हाउ मच इंफॉर्मेशन टू बी एक्सचेंज शेयर और डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड। सो सपोज आई क्रिएट वन सॉफ्टवेयर, ठीक है, आई हैव वन आईपीआर, ठीक है, मेरे पास एक आईपीआर है, कोई भी प्रॉपर्टी हो सकती है, मेरी पेंटिंग हो सकती है, मेरी कोई बुक लिखी हो सकती है, मेरे आइडियाज हो सकते हैं, तो ये इट इज माई राइट हाउ मच आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर एंड हाउ आई वॉन्ट टू हूम आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर एंड हाउ मच ईयर आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर, दिस इज माई राइट, क्लियर? दिस इज कॉल्ड आईपीआर, ठीक है? तो इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी देर इज अ राइट एंड आईपीआर स्टैंड फॉर इट इज ए राइट ऑफ ए पर्सन टू डिसाइड हाउ मच इंफॉर्मेशन टू बी शेयर एंड हाउ टू हूम यू वॉन्ट टू शेयर दी इंफॉर्मेशन। क्लियर? सो आई क्रिएट वन सॉफ्टवेयर, ठीक है, सॉफ्टवेयर की कोडिंग अगर कोई मेरी कोडिंग को कोई थेफ्ट कर लेता है, ठीक है, इन दैट केस आई कैन लॉग इन ए कंप्लेंट, अदरवाइज देर इज नो एनी फिजिकल थिंग इज हियर, जस्ट एक सॉफ्टवेयर, बट इट मीन्स योर दिस इज योर आईपी, ठीक है, तो आप उसको प्रोटेक्ट कर सकते हो। So there are different methods to protect IPR. There is a copyright, there is a patent, there is a trademark. Now, what is copyright and what is trademark and what is patent? So first I will discuss patent. Patent is a monopoly right on any product. For example, monopoly, what is as a commerce student, what is monopoly data? मोनोपोली राइट, यस बेटा,
सर मोनो मीन्स ए सिंगल एंड पॉली मोनोपोली मीन्स अ सिंगल सोल राइट।
यस वेरी गुड बेटा। फॉर एग्जांपल इन इंडिया, इंडियन रेलवे हैज ए मोनोपोली इन रेलवे, ठीक है, क्योंकि इंडिया में जो रेलवे, इंडियन रेलवे है उसकी मोनोपोली है, तो पेटेंट इज ए मोनोपोली राइट ऑन एनी पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट। तो ये कौन सा प्रोडक्ट हो सकता है? फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज ए यूनिक आइडिया जो अभी तक है ही नहीं। फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू सपोज यू डेवेलप एन आइडिया टू क्रिएट पेट्रोल फ्रॉम ए प्लांट, क्लियर, एंड दिस इज एक्सक्लूसिव आइडिया एंड यू कैन गेट पेटेंट ऑन दैट, क्लियर? इट मीन्स इफ अनदर पर्सन वांट टू यूज द सेम आइडिया, ही और शी विल हैव टू पे द मनी टू यू, इट मीन्स यू आर द ओनर, he or she will have to get the permission from you. So this is monopoly. It means you will have to decide to whom and how much information you want to share. Clear? This is called patent. So patents are basically given on softwares, given on medicines, given on the unique products. Clear? So this is a
ये एग्जांपल कि आरबीआई के पास मोनोपोली है इंडियन नोट्स इंडियन करेंसी प्रिंट करने के लिए।
देखो जो पेटेंट होता है वो ग्लोबल होता है, ठीक है, तो इफ आरबीआई हैज द मोनोपोली ऑन प्रिंट इन द करेंसी इन इंडिया, व्हाट अबाउट द यूएसए एंड यूके? क्लियर
सर? आरबीआई के पास तो इंडिया के नोटिस से वही छापते
हैं। हां बेटा, मोनोपोली पूरे ग्लोबल होता है, क्लियर? पेटेंट पूरा ग्लोबल होता है। इसका मतलब अगर मैं, अगर सपोज हुंडई कंपनी हैज ए मोनोपोली, हैज ए पेटेंट ऑन कार, इट मींस नो एनी अदर कंपनी कैन मेक कार विदाउट द परमिशन ऑफ हुंडई कंपनी, बट medicine, your Ayurvedic medicines, in India is very far behind the other countries for registration of patents. Clear? In China is the number one for registration of patents. वो कोई भी software बनाते हैं, कुछ भी बनाते हैं, तो बहुत जल्दी इसको patent करवा लेते हैं. But in India, this process is very slow because the ignorance of the people. Next is, next in your syllabus is after patent, there is copyright and trademark. Okay, students. Have you observed the sign of LG company or Samsung? There, the word is there. The font size, font style is totally different. Samsung, LG, okay. For example, Canon, okay, HP, Hyundai ka H, then Honda H. So these are signs or symbols that represent any company, represent any company. This is called trademark. So there is a trademark is always displayed with the help of one circle and T inside, TM. TM stand for trademark. So trademark jo hota hai aapke paas, wo aapke paas kisi bhi particular एक सिंबल के ऊपर होता है, एक साइन के ऊपर होता है, जो किसी की भी कंपनी को यूनिकली आइडेंटिफाई करता है। तो ट्रेडमार्क इज अ सिंबल, ठीक है, इज अ राइट गिवन ऑन एनी सिंबल, ठीक है, क्लियर? अर्चिका, इट्स क्लियर बेटा? ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉपीराइट. Now, copyright is given on any product, on the shape of a product. For example, Swift, it is a product of Suzuki company. This model structure, the look of Swift has a copyright. It means no any other company can copy the same style, same model, same name of the model. The same way i20 is a model, i10 is a model of is a product of Hyundai company, so and no any other company can copy that model, okay, copy the name or copy the shape, clear? So this is copyright is always on a product, model, shape, okay? So this is, these are the three things which are very helpful for protecting IPR. तो आईपीआर को अगर आपने प्रोटेक्ट करना है तो यू हैव वन इज कॉपीराइट, सेकंड इज पेटेंट, थर्ड वन इज ट्रेडमार्क, बट दीज आर डिफरेंट इन देयर एप्लीकेशन एरिया. पेटेंट इज गिवन फॉर एक्सक्लूसिव आइडिया, ओके, एंड कॉपीराइट इज गिवन ऑन एनी प्रोडक्ट शेप, प्रोडक्ट नेम, ओके, एंड द ट्रेडमार्क इज गिवन ऑन द कंपनी साइन और symbols, okay, these are given today. This is called trademark. So these are the three things. Any doubt in this, beta? So next is violation of IPR. No. We know that in computer, suppose I give one project work. What you will do? Normally, the student do they copy the data or contents from internet, okay, without the giving the information to the teacher. So this is a violation of IPR, because whenever you place some text, some material in internet, that is a IPR, that come under IPR. And if you are copying that, it means you are violating IPR. So there are a different way by which you can violate the IPR. First one is plagiarism. So in your classes, the plagiarism topic is in syllabus. Plagiarism means copying the idea of another person without his or her knowledge or without any acknowledgement. Suppose I am copying the data from any website and I am not giving that information in my project work. So this is a plagiarism. So plagiarism just copying or kidnapping the idea of another person. So this is called plagiarism. Himanshu, clear beta?
Yes, sir, it's understood.
Okay. Now, plagiarism, simply you can avoid the plagiarism. Mention the source from where you receive this information. For example, suppose you receive the information from a particular website like Wikipedia. So whenever in your project work, there is a bibliography. Mention there the bibliography. In bibliography, this is the there is a in from this website you copied the data. Okay, so this is called acknowledgement. So why when you give the acknowledgement to any person or any website, it means this is not plagiarism. If you are copying that without any knowledge, without any information, this is called plagiarism. Gaurav, it's clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, basically, plagiarism is applicable only the literature material, ठीक है? तो आपके पास आपने कोई भी अगर वर्क करना है, अगर आप इवन इफ यू आर कॉपिंग द डाटा फ्रॉम अनदर पर्सन एंड मैनिपुलेटिंग द वर्ड्स, दिस इज स्टिल प्लैगरिज्म. क्लियर? इन प्लेस ऑफ वन वर्ड यू यूज अ डिफरेंट वर्ड. सो इफ आइडिया इज सेम, इट इज प्लैगरिज्म. एंड सेकंड, द फर्स्ट इज इन वायलेशन वी डिस्कस प्लैगरिज्म. In second, that is copyrighted infringement. So copyright infringement means copyrighted work without the consent of without the consent. You are using the for example, one company is making a car and its shape is similar to the Swift model, and or using the same word Swift. So this is called copyrighted infringement. Okay, so it means you are using the copyrighted work without the consent or permission of copyright holder. Clear? So I am typing the definition of plagiarism first. It means stealing. So plagiarism, just like the dictionary meaning is stealing something. ठीक है? तो plagiarism जो आपके पास in computer we can say it is stealing someone else, work, without his permission or acknowledgement. ठीक है, तो आपने उसकी acknowledgement के बिना ही, if you are using that, so that is called plagiarism. And what is copyright infringement? So I am typing here the definition here. It refers to using copyrighted work without the consent or permission of the copyright holder. This is the.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
सर अगर हम मान लो कि कॉपीराइट है, कॉपीराइट होल्डर के बिना उसका कोई काम, उसका जो प्रोजेक्ट है वो हम फॉलो कर रहे हैं कॉपी, तो सर कोई करे हमारे से स्टील करे हमारा डाटा, तो हम कोर्ट अप्रोच कर सकते हैं? कोर्ट अप्रोच
नहीं कर सकते बेटा, कॉपीराइट आपका नहीं है. द पर्सन हु द इंफॉर्मेशन, द ओनर ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन कैन क्लेम इट. क्लियर बेटा?
नहीं, अगर कोई हमारा डाटा करे स्टील ऐसे
आपको करें तो यू कैन फाइल कंप्लेंट.
ओके,
नेक्स्ट इज, थर्ड वन इज ट्रेडमार्क इंफ्रिंजमेंट. सो हियर just like a copyright, there is a trademark infringement. It means you are using the trademark of another person without his or his consent. Okay, so for example aapne dekha hoga kai bar aise products hote hain jiski shape similar hoti hai. Theek hai, for example आपने एक प्रोडक्ट परचेज किया, देयर इज अ पेन फ्रॉम रेनॉल्ड कंपनी एंड देयर इज सम चेंज इन द स्पेलिंग ऑफ रेनॉल्ड कंपनी एंड द कैरेक्टर्स आर देयर टू और थ्री कैरेक्टर्स आर डिफरेंट एंड यू थिंक दैट दिस इज रेनॉल्ड कंपनी पेन एंड यू परचेज दैट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड विच वन? ट्रेडमार्क इंफ्रिंजमेंट. क्लियर? सो इट्स डेफिनेशन इज अगेन दिस इज पनिशेबल अंडर एक्ट अंडर लॉ. बेटर it is the unauthorized usage of a mark that is identical or descriptively similar to a registered trademark. ठीक है, तो आप यहां तो सेम नेम यूज कर रहे हो और आप या फिर आप ऐसा नेम यूज कर रहे हो दैट इज वेरी सिमिलर. क्लियर? सो दिस इज कॉल्ड ट्रेडमार्क infringement. Yes, students, any doubt in this? Harshika, it's clear? Now, next is, so we discussed here plagiarism and copyright infringement and trademark infringement. Now next topic is open source software. Clear? So now in the class 9 and 10, in your syllabus there is an open source software. So there are basically, when we discuss about softwares, there are different type of softwares. So I'm giving one here. Introduction about the different type of softwares. There are system softwares. There are application softwares. System softwares are the operating systems or the software that are very important for your device. For example, Android, or in the case of Apple, there is a Mac. Here, there is application software that are not for smooth running of your computer system or device. That is only for doing a particular task. For example, if you want to create a spreadsheet, Excel is here. Okay. So now these softwares are of rather two categories, different categories. There are different type of softwares. Some softwares are called firmware. There are shareware. Clear? There are some proprietary software or paid software, or there is some open source. Now tell me, what is firmware? Any student? Yes, Gaurav. Yes, Gaurav, what is firmware? Isha. Himanshu.
सर नहीं, कोई एग्जैक्ट डाटा नहीं, एग्जैक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं है मेरे पास, प्रॉपर नहीं है मेरे पास.
आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट. बेटा शेयरवेयर, व्हेन वी यू स्टार्ट योर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम, देयर इज सम बायोस. स्क्रीन के ऊपर एक बेसिक इनपुट आउटपुट सिस्टम के ब्लैक कलर की स्क्रीन आती है, किसी भी डिवाइस को स्टार्ट करती है, कंप्यूटर को स्टार्ट करती है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वहां पे if your computer is of Dell company, the Dell sign will be there, and there press F1 to continue like this. Okay, this is called firmware. The main purpose of firmware is to start your device, to boot your device. Then there is a shareware. These softwares are also called trial based software. They are free of cost for a period. For example, 1 month. Okay. After 1 month, that software will be disabled. Clear? Or during the 1 month period or time period, there are some top options are active, some are passive, means disabled. So shareware softwares are free for short period. And after a short period, completion of short period, you will have to buy that software. Freeware. Freeware softwares are those software that is free of cost. It means you can download it from internet, you can use it, you can get from your friends, no any type of payments you will have to give. Okay, next software that are called paid software or proprietary software means you will have to buy that, you will have to purchase that. Proprietary softwares, if you want to use that, you will have to pay the money. It means if you are not paying the money and using the software, this is illegal. This is called pirated software. Clear? So this is called proprietary softwares. Proprietary software means paid software. You will have to make the payment for using that. Another type of software is called open source. Because whenever you use the Microsoft product, the products are available, you can use it, but the coding in which these softwares created are not disclosed by the company. So coding is not available in internet or in any other mode, but in the case of open source, if you the coding is available in internet, coding is free of cost. It means you can download the coding, you can modify it, and after that, you can reintroduce your software. But you can't make it use it as a commercial use. For example, you are selling that product. Nominal charges you can charge, but for professional purpose, for a commercial purpose, you can't use that. Here, this is called open source softwares. So these are the five categories of softwares: firmware, shareware, freeware, proprietary software, and open source. Next is licensing. So just like in proprietary software, when we install the software, then you accept terms. That terms is called license. Clear? In the same way, when you install any open source software, there is some terms. You accept that terms, then you can install your software. That is called license. And in the case of open source, there are different type of license. There is a Creative Commons, there is a GPL, there is a Apache. And these different type of license are different in their permissions. It means in some licenses are very liberal, some are very strict. Clear? So according to the type of your license, the distribution and usage of open source software are dependent. So now we are going to discuss these different software license. First license is Creative Cloud. In short, we are saying it CC license. CC license. It is called Creative Commons. The full form is Creative Commons. So it gives permission to copy, modify, distribute the original work by attributing the creator of the world. It means in this type of permission, you can copy the software, you can modify, you can redistribute it, but you will have to give the acknowledgement of the original owner. Clear? So simply mention the originally this work was developed by this person, and this is called Creative Commons, and this is normally we use. Okay, to any doubt in this? The time is over. Yes, students clear? Himanshu clear?
Yes, sir. I have sent you the attendance, sir.
Okay. Thanks for attending the class. Now I am going to close the meeting, but